Hey, audio storytellers. I am just taking a quick break from repainting our bedroom. Sorry, the room is totally empty, so apologies for the echo. To talk about something that can be really important in framing how we approach our creative work as podcasters, and that is what makes a professional. Now, the first thing that comes to mind when we often ask ourselves how we define professionalism is money, because having a job or getting paid to do something is the easiest and simplest way sometimes to define whether you are a professional or a hobbyist. But I find that using money as the yardstick is very reductive, and it can put the emphasis on the wrong things rather than the quality of the work. And getting paid may or may not be within your control. Full-time jobs in podcasting are not that common. So I wanted to share what I believe is a more empowering and internally referenced definition of professionalism. And this is inspired by a book I'm reading called The Soul of a Chef by Michael Ruhlman. Obviously, working in a professional kitchen is extremely challenging, as any of you who have done so will know, but I think there are some really fantastic lessons about artistry and dedication and skill, including this passage which I will read to you. So the author goes to the Culinary Institute of America and signs up for a class because he wants to write about learning to cook at a professional level. And so he says this: "I learned mental flexibility. You can accomplish anything, anything at all, if you set your mind to it. One must adopt a can-do anything attitude. You were a professional. You didn't say no, not ever. You didn't complain. You didn't get tired, and you showed up no matter what. You got there. Nothing but nothing kept you from reaching that kitchen. Also, you accepted the implicit obligation of excellence. Every effort would be your absolute best. Otherwise, it was simply not worth doing. At the same time, you accepted that your best was never your best and could never be, because you could always work faster, cleaner, more efficiently." Again, Michael Ruhlman, The Soul of a Chef. And what I love about that definition is that it focuses on a growth mindset and things you can control, which are your learning, your skill development, and the quality of your work, and meeting your obligations. For example, if your published date is Wednesday, to be a professional, you are going to hit that published date every week. If you have decided that your audio editing ethos is to edit out all the mouth clicks and all the breaths, then you edit out all the mouth clicks and all the breaths. Or if your approach is to write and revise your scripts three times, then every episode you write and you revise your scripts three times, because that is the commitment to excellence, which I think is a more helpful and empowering definition of what professionalism is than simply money. So there you go. Hope that's an encouragement.